Hey, how's it going? This is Carter Troughton with OBTFishing.com, and tomorrow morning I'm going out to Cottage Grove Lake with one of my buddies, Chris Parks, and it's going to be some post-spawn summer largemouth action. Should be a lot of fun. But I thought I would just give everyone a quick briefing on what's going on tomorrow, what the weather's going to be like, some of the plastic lures I might be using, and so on. So check it out.
Just going to use my iPhone here real quick, go to the weather page, and I'm at Cottage Grove. It's currently 64 degrees, and tomorrow it's going to get up to 93. Wow. Out here in Oregon too, we're going through definitely a heat wave.
Right here, this is people's worm. This is what I'm probably going to catch a lot of fish on tomorrow. It's just a phenomenal looking bait in the water. All right, we're out at Cottage Grove Lake now. Time to go fishing. It's about 8 a.m.
It's middle of August. We've got water dropped a little bit, and fish, I don't know, I've got a feeling they've pulled out somewhat to some breaks, steeper stuff, more main lake features. So we're gonna go look around a little bit, use our electronics today to find some breaks and see if we can't catch them a little bit.
Okay, we're gonna use this worm as kind of a search bait. Got like a quarter ounce weight and a finesse worm. Basically I call it like a power finesse setup because you're running a finesse bait right here, but you're also doubling your weight in the front because you're fishing pretty deep. So it's gonna help me to cover water pretty quickly, get down into, 15 to 20, 30 feet of water. Within a few seconds, it's not going to be too slow a fall. It's going to kind of power down there. Hopefully find a few fish that are pretty active. Come up and get a hold of it. Yeah, you can see this little stobber there. It could be a rock, could be kind of a flat stump, could be a few things, but you can see the graph right now starting to jump a little. It's starting to get little fingers in there. And that's just is broken rock. Could be a little bit of deep grass. It's all good stuff. It's all transition stuff. Something different down there for these fish to relate on. Stuff for food to hold in, crawdads, sculpin, little catfish. And we try to stay on top of that and shoot some fish.
And we are out literally in the middle of the lake.
Nice. It's kind of moved off here to a different spot. But we were casting, first cast, and then we got ourselves a pretty good.
I don't think the camera can get it yet.
Wow, dude.
Yeah, I think it's pulling.
Oh, wow. There he is. That'll eat, huh?
Damn. Good bass.
Definitely a good fish. Wow, it's like upper threes, maybe 4 pounds.
All right, so what I'm doing right now is I got a quarter ounce drop shot and a 6-inch people's worm. I'm just kind of dragging it off the bottom, about 15, 20 feet, just skipping it, bouncing it over these rocks, letting it drag. And when I feel that pressure, when I feel that bite, I just gotta reel into it and really get that hook set. But, moving along this bank and see what we can find. All right, I got a good fish on right now.
What do you get him on?
Worm. Drop shot. Ooh, mama!
Let me hold. Got my rod in there and everything. Yeah, buddy. That's a good fish. You gotta get the lay down in there. Oh. Nice, nice.
Cool. Solid drop shot fish. Definitely over 3 pounds, maybe 3.5 or so.
Here, step back just a little bit.
So yeah, building up that 5-fish limit right now.
Right here, you can see you got some rock, and all of a sudden you got a big grass clump out here in about 17 feet or so, maybe 15, up on this rising down. You got some rolling bottom. It gives these fish a lot of different places to hang out. And There was one hanging in there and Carter took advantage of that a minute ago.
We've been going down the same stretch of bank now for probably like 25, 30 minutes. No more bites at the moment, but see some interesting stuff here on the graph. Some more rock piles, humps, and stumps. Just rolled up to the third spot of the day, really.
Yeah, I mean, the totally different spot. We fished like basically channel edge to begin with, and then we went to a riprap bank, and now we're just kind of on a long sloping point with a little bit of scrap and wood on it. But yeah, we're kind of keep things in the same depth zone, you know. We're trying to fish 10 to 30 feet, really, 15 to 30 feet would be where the biters are at. The wind picked up a little bit. We missed another good fish about 20 minutes ago, so there's a little bit of a bite out here. It's kind of tough, but it's still worth making a couple casts for. So I'm gonna keep out with this little worm, keep the power finessing going a little bit. Coming up.
Parks is on the phone right now.
Let me call you back, bud. I'm calling you back. There's one right there. It's off the point.
Oh, yeah. One. Woo!
Nice. About 20 feet deep or so. Just threw out there parallel with that little worm and got a nice keeper to eat it. That's on this fish. There it is.
Keeper number three.
Worm bass. Oh, dude, this is a big one. Here, bud, I gotta go again. Come on. Yeah, we're like 23 feet of water, dragging a worm across a point. I just hooked up a little pretty good. This feels like it could be one of the bigger ones of the day.
Fish number four.
Almost got a county limit. Looking good. Looking like a fish. Didn't move out of my parents' house. 26 years old, living at home. Got no job, got no future. Just bass fishing with a palm buster today.
All right, so I'm still throwing that same drop shot set up, quarter ounce, the people's worm, 6-inch. We're just kind of moving along this rocky bank now. We're on our way to this dam area. It's pretty concentrated with bass, pretty much, I don't know, for most part of the year. So might be able to get our fifth keeper off the end. We'll see.
Slick, burn and drag, burn and drag. Oh, it's a big one. Oh, it just came unbuttoned.
All right, so my big camera just died, but I got the iPhone. So we're gonna try and get some video with it. What just happened?
Yeah, we just stuck a pig probably about 30 feet of water. Came off right at the boat. It was a 4.5 to 5 pound fish. Kind of messing with him a little bit of the boat, trying to get him to jump and stuff, which was smart, but nonetheless, it was a good fight. Nice fish. You know, we're about at the great end of the day here. I'm going to fish around a little bit more. We'll give a little recap here in just a minute. Here's a couple of the better fish we caught today. Definitely just kind of went out and ran a summer pattern on plastics in deeper water. Came up with a couple of good ones. We got about a 16 to 17 pound five fish limit today. Fishing a couple hours, but yeah, overall pretty decent day really, and we kind of grinded it out and it entitled us to a couple bites, so can't get much better than that really, and we'll be back out.